It's time for the All-Star Family Feud Special. Introducing for the first game, the Barney Miller family. Hal Linden, Ron Carey, Ron Glass, Steve Landesberg, and Jack Sue. Ready for action. Playing against the Eight Is Enough family. Lonnie O'Grady, Susan Richardson, Diane Kay, Lori Walters, and Grant Goodeve. On your marks. Let's start the All-Star Family Feud Special. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Welcome back. Thank you. That was lovely applause. Was that live or was that Memorex? Never tell. Oh, but listen, if you love football and you're an LA Rams fan, I got good news and bad news. Bad news, the Rams are going to move to Anaheim. The good news is that's the most yardage they've made in 3 years. All of the shows that we have on here, Welcome Back, Kotter, Soap, Eight Is Enough, Barney Miller, are constantly in the top 10. I'm really grateful because this is the day off. When you work in a series, it's a hard day. They've given up their days to come in here, all of these performers, to work for charity. We've got over $20,000 to give away. We want to give it away. How do you play the game? It's very simple. We ask 100 people all over the country by mail just answers to certain questions. All our celebrities have to do is try and guess what the answers were of the average American. It's that simple. They're playing for a good cause. A lot of the money will go to needy, worthy causes. I believe some of it's going to the comedy department at NBC. So we're going to have a good time. Will you help me welcome, please, Barney Miller? Thank you. How are you doing?
Good.
Good. All right. Who are you going to play for? What charity?
First, well, we are playing for Jack Sue's favorite charity, the City of Hope at Duarte.
Magic. Okay.
And if I'd known it was going to be formal, Richard, we would have dressed. But...
Well, I saw you at the Emmys, and you look so smart. I thought, well, what the heck? You were there when the president very mm-hmm. smartly interrupted
I came there for my annual loss.
You do it with such dignity,
yes,
though.
I do it with dignity.
How are you?
Fine.
Good to see you.
Terrific.
I'm delighted. You know I'm a big fan. I'm happy to have you here.
Oh, thank you.
Why are you laughing? I can do that. It's all right.
Okay. How are you?
Fine.
He's obviously right now the fashion plate of the... You're a very neat dresser. Oh, you really are.
Thank you. Thank you.
I saw a show recently where you played a lady.
Right.
And you shaved the mustache off. You looked absolutely dynamite. I mean, you really did. No, I only say that on Hogan's, twice a year, I played a lady. I always played an old lady. Of course, you get a war. I got the Maudy Frigate Award. Was it fun to do that? Did you feel very self-conscious?
At first, but it got all right.
Did they let you keep the dress? Always made me give it back. How are you, Rascal?
How are you? Richard?
We're just holding hands. Have you ever seen this man in the club, dynamite, off the wall, a little weird, funny?
Thank you, Richard. Very nice to see you.
Very nice to see you, too.
Are you still English?
What time is it now? Yes, I am. I thank you for being here. Let me give you a little hug. You're a special man, and I'm delighted to have you here.
Thank you.
You're not nervous, are you?
You forgot to wash the dishes.
Oh. I thought we'd never talk about that on the air. Here's the one who challenged you, call 8. It's enough, ha!
Thanks,
thank you for being here.
And we're glad to be back.
We're here on our very first special. Who are you playing for, Lynn?
American Cancer Society in memory of Diane Hyland.
Oh, that was exactly the same. We wish you luck here, okay? Hi, pretty.
Hi.
How are you?
He closes his eyes, Susan. You're right.
He fooled me the last time. Oh. Plastic lips. Remember that?
You know, those cute parts.
How are
Hello.
You?
Hello. Nice to see you.
You're gorgeous.
Thank you.
Our Wid Ross and Snappy Dresser Award is over here now. Is that a...
Yeah.
That's
the one's in the middle.
Very elegant.
You got it. You lift it right there.
Oh, well, I...
Oh.
Remember we asked the other day, where have all the flowers gone? You had them, didn't you? Thank you. We're delighted. Thank you very much. Grant, right. I thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Ready
thank
to
you.
Do it?
All ready.
Yes. Let's yes. play the feud. All right, now here's a chance for you to get $5,000, and then you'll be in the finals. Whoever wins that, they'll get a chance to play for $10,000. A lot of money at stake. 100 people surveyed, top five answers are on the board. You have to try and find the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name someone famous for taking his or her clothes off. Yes, sir.
Gypsy Rose Lee.
Lover Gypsy Rose Lee. Yay! Number one answer.
That's
amazing.
Pass.
Pass.
Yes.
Gonna pass?
Yes, we're gonna pass.
Now, right away, the number one answer, congratulations. Come on over here, little angel. You see that? 38 people out of our 100 people surveyed said Gypsy Rose Lee. Their strategy is for you to strike out, but you're gonna fool them, aren't you? Maybe you're not. Name someone famous for taking his or her clothes off.
Oh. Burt Reynolds.
Why not?
You got it.
Any of our 100 people say Burt Reynolds. There you go. 15 people said it. You're rolling. Hi, cutie pie.
Hi.
What do you say?
Oh,
saying?
No.
Think nude.
I'm thinking nude. Oh, gosh.
Someone famous for taking his or her clothes off.
My mother.
Your mom. We got 3 seconds.
Oh, shoot. The New Year's baby. I don't know.
New Year's baby?
New Year's baby.
Yeah.
Hey,
that's I think that's compulsory. One New Year's baby, please. Not there.
I didn't think so.
That's a strike. If you get 3 strikes, the Miller group who are plotting at this moment will get a chance to steal. Laurie, someone famous for taking his or her clothes off.
Lady Godiva.
Good girl. Put everything she had, I believe, on a horse. Lady Godiva! Second most popular race. 21 people said it, $74. You're rolling. Grant, what do you say, sir?
Superman.
Aha. Uh-huh.
Not all the way. But
no, just right.
Right.
Yeah. All right. Superman, I'm going to take a look and see if he's there. Superman! Not there. But he does indeed whip them off occasionally. You're so cute. 2 strikes.
You're going to love this one.
Only 2 answers left. I'll love it if it's up there for you. What do
I
you
love
say?
Her, Marilyn Monroe.
Oh, yeah, I loved her.
Did she take a close
she
look?
She surely did for a very famous picture, I believe,
well,
in the first
the only one I can think of.
Edition of Playboy. Is that correct?
No.
And, yeah, and then popular McCann. Marilyn's up there. You're okay. If not, it's your 3rd strike. Way I got out. A feeling she's got to be there. Marilyn!
No!
Not there. Hey, Hal, you can do it right now. Come on, you can steal that money. Have you ever seen such excitement? No wonder there's crime in the streets. What do you say?
You know.
Sally Rand.
We're going to go back to our era. Sally Rand.
Sally Rand.
Uh-oh.
That's the fan
looks,
lady,
looks
right?
Looks like we're dead.
Well, no, the younger crowd.
They don't know. You don't know who Sally Rand is?
Yeah.
Maybe there were some older folks
right.
on that list.
Right. There are 100 people. Right. She's now making atlases. And if Sally Rand's up there, hell, you'll get the $74. But if not, oh, you are going to be so happy.
Happy.
Sally Rand!
Hey!
Hey! Fantastic. Number 4. Oh! Linda Lovelace. Did you have that wrong? In a way, I'm proud of you, and in a way, I'm a little ashamed. $74 right there. Nothing there. Come on up, Angel. Ron, I need you. There you go. Gonna wish each other good luck?
Between the two of you.
Good luck.
At least she's my size.
All right, now remember, first family to get $200 gets to play for the $5,000. 100 people surveyed, top 7 answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name a food that often ends up on your clothes. Yes, dog.
Spaghetti.
It's spaghetti. Number 1. You're good, boy. Don't leave me. We'll find out. What are you going to do?
Play. Okay. Why not?
You're going to play. She gave me the number 1. They control it.
I go back.
Okay.
Go
but there's back. No way. You go back and pluck. Last time, you did a great job. You stole the money. Congratulations. A food, please, that often ends up on your clothes.
Gravy.
Gravy! 9 people said it. Good girl. Lori,
yeah.
What do you think?
I think coffee. People spill coffee.
All right. Does anybody spill coffee? Nope. That's a strike.
I do.
Ice cream?
Why not?
Why not?
Sounds like a goodie. Ice cream! $48 there. 1, 2, 3, 4 answers. Name a food that often ends up on your clothes.
Hamburger grease. Hamburger
grease.
If that goes. Yeah. Hamburgers.
Certainly does. Hamburger! Not there. Now you decided to play and now suddenly you got 2 strikes on you. Sweet. What do you think, Donald? Food that often ends up on your clothes.
Chocolate candy.
Chocolate's up there. You're okay. If not, Al, get ready, because you can steal and take a big lead in the game. Chocolate? Not there. What do you say? Come on, champ.
Yeah, come on.
You're rolling along here.
Which one do you think?
Ketchup.
Syrup, guys.
Here
we
go.
Yeah, absolutely.
Unanimity. Ketchup.
Ketchup. And the other one you had was soup. Both good answers. Yeah. Ketchup's up there. You get the $48. You take a big lead in the game. If it's not there, 8 is enough to get that money. Catch up! You got it! Number 5, please. Soup, you had them both there. Number 6? Mustard. And number 7? Pizza. Okay, Barney Miller, you got all the money. 122. You got nothing here. Come on, Angel. Ron, let's go. Good luck to both of you, and I'll tell you right now, the dollar values are doubled. If you win this round, you're going to play for $5,000. Your team has to win it, Angel, to stay in the game, okay? 100 people surveyed. Top 4 answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name a profession almost everyone, sooner or later, consults. Yes, sir.
A doctor.
One doctor for Ron. Number 1 answer.
We'll play.
Okay, 80 people said it out of 100. We doubled. There's $160. Woo-hoo. The only thing you can do is get over there, think of some answers, and hope they strike out. Don't talk to each other now, because you can't help each other. All right, here we go. Steve, name a profession almost everyone sooner or later consults.
Accountant.
Yeah, good answer.
Thank you.
An accountant? Wow. I am in shock because I thought it was a good answer. Yeah. Not there. First strike. Jack. A profession almost everyone, sooner or later, consults. When I snap my hand.
Yeah, what was that?
3 seconds.
Teacher.
A teacher. Okay. Show us teacher. Not there, not there. Still 3 answers left. Who's
all right.
Or what do you say?
I'll go for a lawyer.
A lawyer. Yeah. A profession almost everyone sooner or later consult. If lawyer's up there, you're okay. But if not, I'm going to come over there. You can get into this game. Lawyer. He said, a lawyer! Well done. Okay. Got one, champ?
Yeah.
Name a profession almost everyone sooner or later consults.
A dentist.
A dentist is a good answer, Ken. Surely. Now, I know that he loves this game and plays it at home.
I do.
You come up and we talk about it, and he says, why did you give that answer to those idiots? Now you know that pressure that everybody goes.
Oh, it is. It's killer.
Good answer. I think it's got to be there. And if it is, you're okay. If not, it's your 3rd strike. Dentist! All right, there's $174 there. There's 1 answer left. Name a profession almost everyone sooner or later consults. 3 seconds.
Thank you. Mortician.
That's later. I swear to you. The people that watch the show that we do every day during the week know that I do not know what's up. That's a dynamite answer. And I got a feeling.
That's dynamite guy.
But it is. But accountant was a good answer. Was not there. I just never occurred to me. But if mortician's up there on the board, You'll have all the money. You will have shut out. Eight is enough. You will play for $5,000. You'll be in the finals to play for an additional 10. If not, I'm coming over there, Rangers. You get a chance to steal. Mortician! I thought you... Did you have it?
We had clergy or mortician. Both of them we had ready.
Listen. Okay. I just came over here. They had another good one, clergy, and they also had the mortician.
Yeah.
So you were all loaded there, waiting to get it, and you got no money here this time. I know because of the last time. You'll stay here and root for them.
You
know they're playing for a good cause. All of the good people at Duarte and the City of Hope, you got a big chance. I need two people right at this moment now who will come out here and play them. Who's going to do it? Let's go. Who'll go first? Jack, go to your room, please. Okay, let's see if Barney Miller can get 5,000 right after we watch this. Okay, champ, so far you got $312. Okay, we got Jack off stage. He cannot hear us, earphones on. I'll ask you five questions. Give me five answers in 15 seconds, trying to get the most popular answer. And if you and Jack get 200 points, we will give you, for your charity, City of Hope at Duarte, $5,000. And we'll be going. Okay. 15 seconds, please. Name something a boxer does to keep in shape.
Run.
Something people put on hot cereal.
Milk.
A color of a jelly bean.
Red.
Part of a chicken.
Wing.
The age a boy becomes a man.
21.
Turn around. See how well you did, Jack. Said name something a boxer does to keep in shape. And you said? Run. Our survey said? 33. Beautiful stuff. Something people put on hot cereal. You said? Milk. Our survey said? 41. 74. You are good. Color of a jelly bean. You said? Red. Our survey said? 41. Part of a chicken, you said. Wing, our survey said. 23, you got 138. The age of boy becomes a man, you said. 21, our survey said. You got 169. Clear the board. Come back, let's see him do it. And here's Jack. Come on, Jack. There you go. Home! 31 points away from $5,000, okay? You know we want you to have it. I'm going to ask you the same questions I asked Ron. You cannot duplicate his answers. If you do, you hear this. I say try again. You give me another answer, okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Would you remind everyone, please, the answers Ron gave us? They were dynamite answers. And give me 20 seconds on the clock, please. 31 points from $5,000. Here we go. Name something a boxer does to keep in shape.
Train.
Something people put on hot cereal.
Syrup.
A color of a jelly bean.
Red.
Try again.
White.
A part of a chicken.
Leg.
The age a boy becomes a man.
13.
Turn around.
I'm Jewish.
You know, yeah.
I'm Jewish.
You don't
look
it.
I'm a man at 13.
Well, why not? You cannot do a show now without entering political debates. Here we go, champ. Name something a boxer does to keep in shape. And you said, train. Our survey said, zero. We need two people to say that. They did not. The number one answer was jumps rope. Number one answer. Still need 31. What, did you lose a window? Why don't you put your arms in? Here we go. Something put on hot cereal. You said. Syrup, our survey said.
You got it, Jeff.
Sugar, Jack, number one answer, sugar. Color of a jelly bean. You said. White, our survey said. Zero.
Oh, jeez.
Number one answer so was red.
Play for that leg.
Part of the chicken. 31 points for the charity and the right to play with these gentlemen one more time. Boy, this, I mean, become a man by all means, but this is ridiculous. You said a part of a chicken was a leg. 31 points, $5,000. Salvation for Jack, and our survey said...
I'm Jewish.
All right, they're in the final, so we're going to come back. But welcome back, Kotter and Soap.
It's time for the second game of the All-Star Family Feud Special, introducing the Kotter family. Ron Palillo, Marcia Strassman, Charles Fleischer, Stephen Shortridge, and John Sylvester White, ready for action. Playing against the Soap family, Diana Canova, Jay Johnson, Robert Mandan, Dinah Manoff, and Jimmy Bio. On your marks for the second game of the All-Star Family Feud Special.
Hey, hey, hey.
And here once again is the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
How are you, Ken?
Nice to see you.
Neat show, and I'm glad you're here. We've worked together.
Yes, we have.
Did match game before. Who are you going to play for, by the way?
We are playing for the Autistic Children's Foundation.
A worthy cause. Thank you.
Thank you.
We had hoped to have Gabe here, but he's opposed to being bussed. School teacher joke for himself. Hey, now, I happen to... Because I heard somebody told that you were in rehearsal, you're going to do
yes.
a show. What are you going to do?
I'm going to be playing the Artful Dodger in Oliver.
Dynamite. Hi, pretty.
Hello.
You're gorgeous.
Oh, thank you.
We've known each other a long time, and
yes.
I'm flattered that you're here and honored. You're
oh,
a darling.
Well, thank you.
I want you to win a lot of money.
You look real cute.
Oh, thank you, dear. Thank you. Charles, how are you?
Very good.
Hand class.
Thank you very much.
Not nervous.
Huh?
You always have little dry lips. Not nervous, are you?
Huh?
We'll move on to the new one, shall I?
New one.
New one.
Very well.
New
good.
Boy.
Keep taking the tablets. I'll be back. How you doing?
Fine, how are you?
We saw a little heartthrob there. I saw all the giggles and the squeals.
Well, they're surrounded by those ladies.
Just blow his career right out the window now. Are you married?
Yes.
Yeah, gotcha. Yeah, I knew it. You gotta be cruel to be kind sometimes, right, John?
True, Richard.
Everything fine?
All right, Richard.
All ready to do it?
There we go.
Playing for a good cause. Here's a family want to get ready if they can. They call the Soap! Thank you for coming.
Sure.
Yeah, they were here before and they're great. Who are you gonna play for, then?
The Seeing Eye Dogs of America.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
I thank you, Betty White, thank you.
I know.
All the people. Yeah. I bet it was one of Betty's ideas because she likes it.
Oh, she loves
it. I give her sometimes, I'll send some money to her for Christmas or something to buy a gift for somebody, and she always gives it to the
right
Seeing
to the,
Eye Dogs.
That's right.
That's a great. We thank you.
Okay.
How are you?
Hello, Richard. Good to see you again.
Very handsome.
Thank you. Same to you.
No butterflies here. Very
comfortable. Looks like you should be buried in that suit.
Yes, I. Matter of fact, I died a little earlier when we did it. Here's a man who I just thought was a philanderer. I'm watching your show, and you're a murderer as well.
All of those things.
A jailbreaker.
All of those things.
But a good little dancer, right?
Hey. Go out sometime?
Of course. I'll wear this. Hi, pretty.
Hi, Richard.
How are you?
I like your bow tie.
Oh, I like yours.
Thank you.
Want to talk about anything else? No. Jimmy. You've got young people here. How old are you, Jim?
16.
Do you have a steady girlfriend?
Sure.
What's her name?
Humana, 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 humana.
I know her. She chants. Come on, let's play the feud. Let's do it. One in Diana. Here we go. Remember right now, just one hand up there,
yeah,
please. You're playing for $5,000, and whoever wins, they will play for $10,000 against Barney Miller. Barney Miller, by the way, have $5,312. Here we go. 100 people surveyed. Top five answers are on the board. You have to try and find the most popular answer. Kind of a long question, so listen. If you were forced to eat the food of one foreign country exclusively, which country would you choose?
Italy.
Italy! Number one. What are you going to do, sir? Going to play or you're going to pass?
We'll play.
Okay, you want to play? 44 out of 100 people said it. What do you say, Don?
I say France.
You do?
Yes.
Oh, do I love. Manger la France! Yes, sir! 14 people said it. I love Italian, but I get al bloto, you know.
I'll go for the Japanese.
You will. You're not just a pretty face then, child. Did any of our 100 people say, I'll go for Japanese? The answer is no. That is a strike. You get three of those, they get a chance to steal. Steven!
Whoa, I'd say China. Chinese.
You would? Okay. You'll probably say that again in an hour.
I probably will. I like Chinese food.
You should push me out. We'd like Chinese food! You get it! $74 there, there's two answers. What?
Greece.
You would. Okay?
No, I would.
I tell you, he's never lied to me before.
I always eat Greek food.
You do?
I like Greek. Moussaka?
Looking for Greece! Second strike. Ron?
Okay, I would say Mexican.
You would? Okay.
Yes.
Mexican food's up there, you're all right. But if not, it's your third strike, and soap, get ready, because you can all steal, but I got a feeling it's a goodie. Mexican food! All right! $88 is one answer left. Which country would you choose?
Germany?
Germany?
That's good.
Little Venus
schnitzel? That's good.
Sounds
that
like
is
a goodie?
Good. You'll like that.
Well, if Germany is there, you have all the money, alles. But if not, I will go to soap. And you have a chance to steal. Also to take hostages.
I'll let you know. Tell me.
Germany! Yeah! $95 right there. We're going to have a good game right after this.
The All-Star Family Feud Special will continue in a moment.
Okay, Kotter, $95, nothing for soap. Jay, I need you. Come on,
Jay. Good luck, Jay.
There you go. I say good luck to both of you, and I mean it sincerely. 100 people surveyed, top 7 answers on the board. Long question, listen. Name something you had to do as a child that you vowed you'd never do again. After you were grown up.
Yes.
Eat everything on my plate.
Would not eat everything on her plate. Boy, oh boy. One answer better than that. You give me the number one answer. Your controller, Jay. What do you
say?
I say
homework.
Homework. Won't do any old homework. You control it. Are you going to play or are you going to pass?
Pass, pass.
Pass?
Pass.
Pass?
Yeah.
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 They say pass.
They do. All right.
They're all guys, you know.
Okay.
Well, what do you want to do?
If they want to, far be it, if they want to pass.
Yeah?
But if we lose.
Okay, well, you're going to pass. All right, Angel. Very clever the way that she shifted the blame there. Robert.
Mind my parents.
You mean take heed of them?
No, I mean mind my parents.
You do?
Yes.
Yeah.
We understand each other?
Of course we do.
Don't do that.
Yes, sir. Mind his parents! Should have taken heed. That's your first strike. I know.
Go to bed early.
Aha.
Nice.
I like that.
Yeah.
Kind of never, ever going to go to bed early. The number one. Beautiful. 21 of our 100 people polled said it was the number one answer. Jimmy.
Yeah, never drink my milk. Yeah.
Never drink your milk! Second strike. Boy, oh boy. Five answers left.
Clean up my own room.
Clean up your own room. All right. Clean up the room. You got it. Jay. Who's that?
Some I vowed I would never do, but I still have to do it. It's take out the trash.
Take out the trash. Okay. Take out the trash there. You're okay. If not, it's your third strike. Take out the trash. You got it. I don't want any trouble with your parents here now.
Mow the lawn.
Ah. Mow the lawn! Not that. What do you say? Come on down here. Ronnie! Here's the moment now. You should have plotted it all out.
What?
Gonna have the strategy work?
Okay, yeah.
What do you say? Need an answer.
Being home on time.
Okay, that's a good answer. Being home on time. If it's there, you get the $49. If not, you're in this game with the money. So, being home on time. You're in it. Did you have any other thoughts? Oh, yeah. Number three, please. Doing the dishes. Number four. Going to school. And number six. Take a bath. Yes, I think a couple of these people have taken that very seriously. $95 there, $49 there. Robert, I need ya.
Shake my hand.
Very nice of you. This question could win the game. Give you a chance to go for $5,000 and be in the finals to play for $10. 100 people surveyed. Top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something people use if they don't have a napkin. Robert?
Their hand.
Hand! Two answers. I'll read it again. Two answers better than that. Name something people use if they don't have a napkin.
Their sleeve.
One sleeve for Charles. The number one. Playing or passing? Child. What are you going to do? Look out, Vincent Price just came through. Don't kill him. You'll be all right.
This is our new charity.
Now, what are you going to do, play or pass?
Play.
You are going
yes.
to play. Yeah. They're going to play. We'll see you in a minute. There you go. Do with that stiletto heels, you're going to screw yourself in the ground. Stephen, name something people use if they don't have a napkin.
Tablecloth.
Mm. From the film, Breeding Will Act. Any about 100 people say tablecloth? You got it. There's $150 there. John, what do you say, sir?
Well, I say a towel.
Towel! 166. No strikes, one answer left. You're in tremendous position right now. Ron?
An apron.
An apron. Apron? First strike.
Hi there.
Something people use if they don't have a napkin.
Handkerchief.
Good answer. Good.
That's it.
Yes. Yes.
Good answer. I swear I do not know if it's there, but it's a goodie.
I don't
either. If it is, once again, you got it. If not, it's only your second strike for the money and the right to play for $5,000 and challenge Barney Miller. Handkerchief! They get it to you. You have $49. They're not going to get a chance to go for $5,000. Will you stay in route for them for me? Okay. I need two people. Who's going to play right now? Let's go. Who'll go first? Go off there, please. Here we go, Sam. Right here. Congratulations.
Thank you.
There we go. I will ask you five questions. You and Charles get 200 points. You got $5,000 for your charity, and we wish you luck.
Thank you.
Give me 15 seconds on the clock. Name the most popular breed of dog.
Collie.
The speed most people drive.
50.
The most beautiful state.
Florida.
Something that creaks.
Something that creaks. A door.
Something you do with your shoes off.
Walk around barefoot.
Walk around barefoot by Neil Simon. Just move down one, my little angel, there so we can get big pictures of you. Name the most popular breed of dog, we asked, and you said? Collie. Our survey said? 7.
Come on, buddy.
It's bad news to the people who just did the new Lassie series.
Yes.
The speed most people drive. You said 50. Our survey said 0. Wow. Most beautiful state. You said Florida. Our survey said 5. You have 12. You just bought land there. Something that creaks. You said a door. Our survey said 35. Something you do with your shoes off. Almost a compulsory thing. You said walk barefoot. And our survey said 5. It's better than a 0. 52. Clear the board, please. Okay.
Thank you.
We'll see how Charles does. Here's Charles. Let's go, kid. Right there. You're 148 away from the big money. I'm going to ask the same questions I asked Ron. You cannot duplicate his answers. If you do, you hear this. I say try again, and you give me another answer, okay?
Okay.
Good. By the way, Nanette Fabre says hi. Now, would you remind everyone, please, the answers that Ron gave us? When you finish laughing, give me 20 seconds on the clock. Name the most popular breed of dog.
Poodle.
The speed most people drive.
55.
The most beautiful state.
Hawaii.
Something that creaks.
Spider.
Something you do with your shoes off.
Take a bath.
Turn around. Name the most popular breed of dog we asked, and you said poodle. Our survey said 39. Number one answer, poodle. You have 91 points. Speed most people drive. You said 55. Our survey said 19. Number one answer was 60 miles an hour. Now, the most beautiful state. You said Hawaii. Our survey said 18. Pardon? He misheard it. Should I get an answer from him? Name something that creaks.
Oh, creaks. I thought you said creeps. Excuse me. Something that creaks. A...
We're not doing an album here. Just give me an answer.
I see. Something that creaks. A hinge.
Very good. A hinge. Our survey said 0. Door was the number one answer. Something you do with your shoes off. You said take a bath. And our survey said 13. 141. $5 for every point. You got a total of $705. But you are also in the finals, and you're going to meet Barney Miller. You'll be playing for $10,000. The big playoff right after this. Okay. The big moment right now. So far, Kotter, you've won $990. The Barney Miller gang, $5,312. We are now playing for the right to play for $10,000. Ron, hell, let's do it right now. Here you go. This is your luck. I you're both marvelous players, but let me tell you, this is just like the Super Bowl. There's no, we don't go to the 200
No pressure.
But I want to just explain, because there's not three or four questions. There's one question, okay? There's five answers. If you control it, strategy is very important. I want you to understand that. Whoever gets this, they're going to play for $10,000, and I wish you both luck. 100 people surveyed. Top five answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name something that is traditionally done at weddings.
Yep. The toast, the groom toast.
A toast! Wide open for you. Name something that is traditionally done at weddings.
Kiss the bride.
Hell wants to kiss the bride! Number one, are you going to play or are you going to pass?
Play?
I need an answer, gentlemen.
Play?
Never leave the scene of a crime. What are you going to do?
My audience wants us to play.
They're going to play, okay? Get over there and think. You gave me the number one answer. No more talking, gentlemen, because I got to get answers individually for you. Ron, name something that is traditionally done at weddings.
The first dance.
The first dance. A lovely thought, and we're going to see if any of our 100 people said it. The first dance. Not there. That's a strike. Ron.
Exchange rings.
Right. Okay. That sounds like it should be there. Do they exchange rings? You get it again, sir. 38 and only 3 answers left. Steve, name something that is traditionally done at weddings.
What about cutting wedding cake?
Yeah. Why not? All you gotta do is sing of it. We're hoping it's there. Cut the wedding cake! Jack, 2 answers left. 1 strike on you. Give you a chance. Gene Krupa tribute is over now. And something that is traditionally done at weddings.
This is my answer. Throw rice.
Ah. Remember before suddenly he was a man at 13 and now
yes.
Suddenly
well, he was.
You're very wily. Looking to throw rice! You got it. $75 there. There is 1 answer left. Hal, name something that is traditionally done at weddings.
Exchange of vows.
Yes.
Exchange of vows.
Yes.
If that's up there, you are the champs and you'll go for $10,000. If not, it's your 2nd strike. Exchange vows. Okay, Ron.
Yeah.
Name something that is traditionally done at weddings.
Kissing the bride.
Now, oh, all, number one answer, but an excellent thought. It shows your thinking.
What happened to me?
No, it's all right. That happened. That's pressure. Name something that is traditionally done at wedding. 3 seconds. Right now, you can do it.
We got it.
All right. Tell me what it is. If it's up there, you'll play for $10,000.
Throwing the bouquet.
And if that's up there, Cotters, you'll go for the big money. If not, Barney Miller and his crew are the champs. Throwing the bouquet. Okay, thank you. I need 2 people. Who's going to play for the big money? All righty. That's here. You stand right there. Here we go. $10,000. You got almost 1,000, but you can... You've got $1,065. You'll have $11,065. We want you to get it, okay? Truly. Everybody mentally, all over America, please. Cross your fingers, think good thoughts. He can't hear us. 15 seconds, please, on the clock. $10,000. Name something besides an ice cream cone that you can order at an ice cream parlor.
A float.
Something you replace on shoes.
Soles.
An animal that plays with balls.
A kitten.
Something you do when you wake up.
Stretch.
A vehicle with a siren.
A fire engine.
There you go. Name something besides an ice cream cone that you can order at an ice cream parlor, and you said... Our survey said...
15.
Something you replace on shoes, and you said, soles, our survey said. 25, you got 40. Animal that plays with balls, and you said, a kitten, and our survey said, 26, you got 66. Something you do when you wake up, you said, stretch, our survey said, 6, you have 72. Vehicle with a siren, you said, fire engine, and our survey said, you got 107. You're over the mark. Clear the board, please.
Thank you.
Let's hope he does it. Here's Charles. Let's go, Jim.
Come on, Charlie.
You're 93 points away from $10,000. You know, I just want to tell you, and I know that you want to win, try and think of an answer and try and give it. If you try and grab, you know, an answer around, just use that clock up, and we don't want that to happen, Charles, okay?
20 seconds.
All right, yeah.
Très bien.
Now, would you remind everyone, please, the answers that Ron gave us? Give me 20 seconds on the clock, and we're rooting for you, okay? Time will not start until I finish reading the first question. By the way, if you hear the buzzer, it means you've repeated a word that Ron gave us, and you'll give me another answer. Here we go. Name something besides an ice cream cone that you can order at an ice cream parlor.
Sunday.
Something you replace on shoes.
Shoelaces.
An animal that plays with balls.
Seal.
Something you do when you wake up.
Brush your teeth.
A vehicle with a siren.
Ambulance.
All right. Here we go. So name something besides an ice cream cone that you can order an ice cream parlor, and you said Sunday, and our survey said beautiful. The number one answer was Tuesday. No, it was Sunday. Absolutely right. Just checking. 49 points away from $10,000. Something you replace on shoes. You said laces. 49 points. Wouldn't it be beautiful to see it up there? $10,000 riding on it. Our survey said 43. Laces, the number one answer.
Seals.
Now the Kotter group are really excited. They have 6 points from $10,000. An animal that plays with balls. And you said seal. 6 points. $10,000. And I thank you, by the way, for your answer. We could have all been one heck of a lot of trouble. For the big money, our survey said... Beautiful. We'll be back to sum all this up right after you watch this. Thank you. May I just, please. I gotta tell you, this was the second special we did. We hope to do another one. I could not wish for dear, more darling people. Let me tell you, Eight Is Enough played for Diana Hyland, the American Cancer Society. You won no money. We're going to give you $500, and we love you. Soap, we played for the Seeing Eye Dogs of America. You won $49. We will add $500 to that with our love. Thank you. Barney Miller, my old pals at City Hope at Duarte, they have $5,312. And the champs are Kotter. National Society for Autistic Children, $11,065. There they are. You're the champ. Take them.
Thank you.
You got it there, and it says, one of the all-star Family Feud champions. You are all champs. Be nice to each other. Watch us every day. God bless you, and thank you.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.